Hello again, Fantasy Alarm Nation. Justin Fensterman here, and it's time for episode 5 of Fantasy Football ADP TV here on FantasyAlarm.com. Taking a look at some average draft position data from the FFPC, featuring players whose average draft positions we like and others who we don't like as much. Today's episode features 3 running backs and 1 quarterback, and let's not waste any more time and let's get right down to business. Let's cover some players. For a few players who I'm a bit higher on who could be rising up draft boards includes Aaron Jones from the Packers. Jones is in a fantastic situation, and the fact that in some 12-team leagues he could still be around in that early 5th round makes him very appealing in fantasy football. The Packers offense heavily favors Jones, a lot of running and quick passes, and even with A.J. Dillon sharing the backfield with him, Jones had over 200 carries and the most amount of targets he's ever received last season. Jones is a fantastic runner who's averaged over 5 yards per carry for his career. While he only hit the end zone twice on the ground in 2022, he still caught 5 touchdown passes, hitting that mark for the 2nd straight season. With Jordan Love taking over at quarterback and the receiving core going through changes, Jones should still be heavily involved in both facets of the offense, in the rushing attack and the passing attack. Jones will be running behind a strong offensive line, and as Love finds his rhythm, it wouldn't be surprising to see Green Bay rely even more heavily on their ground game early in the season. On average, he's currently being drafted in the late 4th round. He's received no fewer than 63 targets in each of his last 4 seasons. Also on the rise in my eyes, Kirk Cousins. Cousins was just one of 5 quarterbacks to throw over 600 passes last season. He's durable, has good offensive line protection to allow him time to throw, and he's recorded over 4,000 passing yards in 7 of his last 8 seasons. He completed around 66% of his passes in 2022. In leagues with 6 points per passing touchdown, Cousins produced the 7th most total fantasy points last season, and only 4 other quarterbacks threw for more scores than he did. You like that? I do, and if you're one who wants to wait on drafting a quarterback, Cousins is being drafted in that 7th, early 8th round area of FFPC drafts, and he should once again hit QB1 value when all is said and done. He is arguably the best receiver in the game today to throw to in Justin Jefferson, and one of the best tight ends of the game to throw to in TJ Hockenson, among other pass-catching weapons. His career-high 14 interceptions last season doesn't faze me one bit because of the heavy passing volume, and that shouldn't change heading into this season. He's completed nearly 67% of his throws for his career and has thrown 29-plus touchdown passes in 4 of his last 5 campaigns. Now for a few players I'm not as high on, and that will be likely trending down draft boards. Breece Hall. The Jets have a system that will favor the run, and we saw Hall rush for 5.8 yards per carry and run in a score in 4 straight games before tearing his ACL back in late October of his rookie season. Will Hall be ready for the start of the season, and will he be given a full workload immediately upon returning? It's very hard to tell, and the 3rd round price point he requires makes him very risky. The Jets don't have a strong offensive line to protect him. They should pass a bit more as well with Aaron Rodgers under center. Speaking of Rodgers, he took a pay cut recently, and the money on the table could lead to the Jets bringing in another running back such as Dalvin Cook. If Cook signs with the Jets, it will likely lead to a decrease in touches for Hall and will end Hall's chances of being a 3-down back. We can't knock the hustle with Hall. He's a great power runner, but there are red flags surrounding him currently, headlined by the fact that he's coming back from a major injury. Even if the Jets don't end up signing Cook, the asking price is still a bit steep. The Jets' current depth features Michael Carter, who is very capable of handling the pass-catching downs, and the Jets drafted Izzy Abanikanda in the 5th round, and he's not that much smaller size-wise than Hall, and he has speed and some explosiveness and is a solid cutter when given the rock. Another player I'm a bit down on, J.K. Dobbins. Dobbins is starting to fall a bit when it comes to his average draft position. Besides the fact that he wants a new deal and he's threatening not to play, the guy has played in only 8 games combined in his last 2 seasons. When it comes to negotiating a new deal, he doesn't seem to have a leg to stand on, figuratively speaking, of course, but it's no joke that he suffered multiple major lower body injuries over the last few years. Has Dobbins rushed for nearly 6 yards per carry for his career? Yes. Does he have a strong offensive line to run behind? Yes, but something else to take into consideration is that the Ravens have a new offensive coordinator in Todd Monken, and the Ravens system should feature more passing in 2023. They invested in pass catchers in the NFL draft and in free agency, and we can't forget that Lamar Jackson loves to run the ball himself and ran the ball 112 times in 12 games last year. Plus, the Ravens also have Gus Edwards, who is a bigger running back than Dobbins, and has rushed for 5.2 yards per carry for his career, and he could fill in for Dobbins if he does indeed want to hold out, and it wouldn't be too much of a downgrade at the position for Baltimore. Dobbins is the better runner of the two, but Baltimore has multiple players that can run the ball at the end of the day. The injuries, expected scheme change, and contract issues scare me away from J.K. Dobbins in the fifth round. And that is another episode of Fantasy Football ADP TV FA Nation. Check out previous episodes on fantasyalarm.com. And if you haven't played on the FFPC, new users get $25 off their first FFPC entry of $35 or more when they register using promo code ALARM. Draft season is here. It's in full swing. Let's win.